Welcome again to Cooking in Finland. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to get an incredibly crunchy and crisp coating for fish on fish and chips. Part 2 will be on the French fry element next. This is different from any other approach I know of, and there are good reasons why. First, ingredients like eggs and ordinary flour produce spongy batters that will fall off the fish easily and are not crisp. Second, other recipes usually don't prepare the fish ahead of time. I'll explain the chemistry behind this in my next book, Volume 5. But for now, let's just make this. The beer plays a major role in the flavor. Whisk together the marinade made up of part 1 in the ingredients list. Submerge the cod in this for 30 to 40 minutes at room temperature. Then remove the fish and save the marinade. You'll be using this later. Dry the fish off well, then wrap it tightly in cling film. Then you're going to refrigerate this cling filmed fish for at least 3 hours before proceeding. Up to 24 hours is just fine. When it's near the time to finish this, combine the dry ingredients in part 2 of the list, whisking together to mix. Divide this mixture up. Part of it will be used for coating the dry mixture of the fish, and the rest will be made up with the batter. Mix equal parts of the marinade liquid from the fish earlier with the same amount of the dry mix. Use a scale to make sure they're the same amount by weight, and don't use more than half of the dry mix to make the batter because you're going to need that to coat the fish. Whisk the batter together before putting it into a pressure canister. This is the same kind of canister used to make whipped cream. Pressurize the canister with one or two nitrous cylinders, depending on how much batter you're making. Shake it up and then leave it at room temperature for at least 15 minutes before proceeding. Cut slices of the fish. I'm making small slices here because I was making many different tests so I could report to you what the best combination was. You can cut longer slices for serving. Heat your deep fryer to 175 degrees Celsius, that's 350 degrees Fahrenheit, with vegetable oil. Spray the batter out of the pressure canister into a bowl. This will take some shaking and multiple times of pressing the dispensing lever to get it all out. Make sure you have gotten all of it out and there's only gas coming out before you open the canister for cleaning. This is very important. You could have a small explosion of goop everywhere and possibly even be injured. Coat the fish well in the dry mixture. Then dip it into the batter, then back into the dry mixture, then back into the batter again. It's best to use tweezers or tongs here so there are not large areas where your fingers were holding onto the fish. Deep fry for about 4 minutes, could be longer depending on how thick your fish was. Don't overcrowd the fryer. If you have a small deep fryer, don't cook more than 2 pieces at a time. Then drain on paper towel and add a little more salt. Let it cool for 4 or 5 minutes at least before you cut into it and start eating. Listen to the crunch. This will stay crunchy for quite a while after cooking too. The next video will address the chips. Links in the description below will inform you where you can get Volume 4 of my cookbook series on Amazon, but it's also available on iLibris and several other online book dealer sites. As always, a huge thank you to all of my dear members, and a happy holidays to you all.